This is a HeadGum Original.
Jaundiced ears, hear this show, often blear, you can trow, brand new stew, it's called G, eat blue chew, for your pee, I can tell that we are gonna be fiends, yes I can tell that we are gonna be fiends.
It's another edition of Jeffrey O'Brien Needs a Fiend. Right?
I don't know.
Marika, what?
Amir's reaction was so good.
What do you mean so good? He did nothing.
No, he was like,
I said M&M,
that's nothing.
Really, it tickled me.
All right, the song's going to play again, and we each have to go down the line saying how we feel about becoming Jeffrey O'Brien's fiend, starting with Marika.
Over the song or
yeah.
After the song?
Just how do you feel about being my fiend?
I feel ill at being your fiend.
Gianna?
I don't think I want to participate in this one.
I might also take a knee.
I didn't know that was an option.
The episode just started and now nobody's participating whatsoever. Right?
Sure, but
how is that on me?
At least for Gianna and I, we just had to listen to you play different sound effects nonstop for 5 minutes straight waiting
for
Amir.
And it was really loud and I was trying to, you know, do my emails and stuff. Yeah.
Same.
But her emails.
How is that my fault? While we're waiting for Amir because he was late, by the way. You can take your headphones off. I was testing audio and there's no way to do that on mute because I'm sharing the fucking oral.
You weren't testing audio because you weren't sharing your computer sound and I told you that, and then you just for at least 30 seconds straight after just sat there blank faced clicking more buttons.
Yeah, you did do that.
I assume kind of doing some sort of bit where you don't listen to me because nobody listens to me.
What did you say?
I said, Jeff, can you please stop?
And also, stop
Jeff,
testing
you're not
sounds,
sharing
by the
your
way.
Sound.
You just said that you had to sit through 5 minutes of me testing out sound effect buttons, blaring through your ears, distracting you from looking at your emails. But you just said that I wasn't even sharing audio. So I was, before we started, because Amir was late, I'm fucking trying shit out, trying to re-up the soundboard a little bit, try to get some more of this kind of thing going, right? Okay, I kind of wanted the whole song to go.
Yeah, it felt like it was the beginning of something.
What about that?
I heard it.
These are some good ones.
Aren't you guys too young to know what dial-up internet sounds like?
Oh.
If you were born in the late 90s?
I know. I mean, I know of it. I don't
you
remember
know of it.
It,
but you never used it.
Yeah, I know of it.
I used
Jeffrey?
It.
Did you ever use
it? I don't
that?
Know if I used it or not, but I know that sound. And I know that sound from childhood, not from people referencing it now.
Interesting.
That sound would ring... Sorry. That sound would ring through the hallowed halls of a Bainbridge, Ohio, Mons. It's tough sometimes, yeah. anywho, right? We have some stuff to get to today. I'm not going to say it's a lot. Let's start with this. What's in Gianna's kitchen?
That's pretty good.
Right? Gianna,
I loved it.
It's a fucking coin toss, this show, that I said that and you guys crack up and love it. But I start things with a fucking original song and a premise for the show. And everybody's like, I'm not going to participate for some reason.
I participated and I was on the first one.
Gianna, what's in your kitchen? I guess
my
that's
fridge. It's right behind me.
Do you mind?
It's on fire.
Depth or zoom in. Let's open the fridge.
Do you actually want me to open my fridge?
I wouldn't mind. I mean, it's obviously about what's in your kitchen.
I'm not doing that.
This is bullshit.
Sorry.
Fucking bullshit.
Gianna,
what,
I feel
Marika?
I feel like you sometimes post good like food photos, though.
Yeah, I do. I literally don't have any groceries right now, though, so that's honestly why I'm not opening my fridge, because it would be embarrassing.
Amir, what do you got in your kitchen, then?
I'm at the office.
Marika?
I'm also at the office.
This sucks, dude!
Let's There's see your stuff. Kitchen, I guess.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, in your house.
I don't
Show us
to.
The kitchen.
If I get up, my computer's gonna die. I have reasons for not getting up.
And I also have reasons.
We
for
all
not
have
up.
Reasons for not getting up.
Mine are the most valid next to Amir's and Marika's. Yours is in the same room.
But she doesn't have a groceries to share.
Yes. I also have headphones in.
Yeah, that's true.
Wired ones.
We're all tethered.
I was going to say we're tethered.
And isn't that the problem always?
Biden has COVID. Biden has COVID zero, and I'm wondering how you guys think about, feel about his efficacy as a young, hung stud.
Efficacy?
Just how much is he gonna work in like a real world scenario?
Did you see he tweeted, or like rather his team tweeted, I'm sick? And then he like replied to that and was like, I'm sick of Elon Musk putting his nose in politics or whatever, but like the quote retweets are funny.
That's actually really good.
Yeah,
it was
that
like
was fun.
I'm sick, and the quote was like, I told you not to go through his phone, girl.
Long legs. Has anybody seen that? Marika? I'm assuming you have.
No, I don't see horror movies, and I think if you were really a good friend,
that.
You'd know that about me.
Because I would follow you on Letterboxd?
Just like you would know that I'm too scared to see horror movies.
Okay.
And
Gianna?
We've talked about that before.
I haven't seen it, but I do really want to. I love it.
It's hard to
movie.
Bond with everyone at the office when I'm not invited on the offsites anymore.
That's not where
really
Marika talks about her distaste for horror movies.
Yeah.
Though.
I was going to say the late night conversations are.
You also said anymore. Like you went one time.
Yeah.
That's true. There's three. There's three, which means that at one point
and
in time
really
I was allowed.
Sick?
It was hard, right? Because I was worried I had COVID, but I didn't.
Well, you shared a room with Johnny, too.
I know. I didn't even get my own fucking place. A Pietaterra or other one.
And you did get Johnny sick, right? Didn't he get COVID?
I think it's hard because I think people wanted to like pair the young brown guys together. You know, even if I had been there with Mike, I wouldn't have been as fear.
As what?
I wouldn't have been as fear.
As
got it.
Fear?
I was afraid in a way.
Oh. Be fear.
Kelly Ripa compares pimples to nipples and despises the Gen Z pimple patch trend. Thoughts on that? Guys, we have to get the energy up. We have to get it up.
Really,
Amir's looking at other shit. Gianna just woke up from a nap, and Marika's not even trying to be upbeat. It's hard.
I'm on amphetamines right now, so that's crazy of you to say.
We're not giving you a lot, but that headline was also kind of a nothing burger.
Yeah, I mean, I love Kelly Ripa. I think she's great. I used to watch that show the time when I was homeschooled.
It's obviously
but that's a crazy take.
I need energy.
I am giving you plenty.
Oh.
It's also
Yeah, because your microphone keeps unplugging, which is another thing I told you when you were pretending to not listen to me.
This episode has bad Thursday energy.
BTE.
You're gonna... Yeah. Actually, I have a bone to pick with you. Gianna probably has the same bone to pick with you.
You scrapped the last one.
We recorded an episode that we were on together.
That one was garbage!
Oh, you recorded a full episode that you didn't release?
Yes.
Yeah. Not every episode is going to get released. It's happening again. It's happening again.
Exactly. And it's your fault.
It's not my fault. I have stuff. I have stuff and I'm bringing stuff up. You're not saying anything in response.
We literally are.
No, you're not. Not enough for a podcast.
I say something and then you complain after immediately.
That's... This is insane that I'm getting blamed for this. Literally, everyone here did what everyone yells at me for today. Amir was late as hell. He was 15 minutes late. Anya was supposed to show me how to run Riverside before this. She was 28 minutes late.
That's irrelevant right
now. Yeah, that is completely irrelevant.
My point is that everyone's doing what they get on my case about for.
And then
today.
I have a question.
Yep.
Did you edit the video
for
the episode that was not released? Or it ended and you're like, I'm not even going to look
at that.
It was
so bad in the room on the Zoom.
I thought it was fine.
It wasn't bad.
I thought it was fine, too. Though.
It was neutral. It was flat. Talking about shit isn't interesting. We have to get into the joke.
That's what a podcast is.
Oh, God. We're going to have to scrap this one. We're going to have to scrap this one. Anya's coming in. Anya's coming in to save the day. I texted her saying help.
Talking about shit isn't interesting?
No, it isn't interesting enough.
Also,
not for this show.
Why are you bringing up
news headlines?
The whole
point of the show is that it's bad. And like, how can something be so bad that it can't even be on the
bad
podcast?
There's bad that's entertaining bad. There's bad that's entertaining bad. And then there's bad where it's just like flat. It's flatlining. The whole show is dead. The show is gone. The content isn't there. I get it. Everyone else has real jobs at this shit. But I'm hitting a breaking point with the blaming it on me that there's not enough content there.
You asked us about nipple pimple patches.
And then brought up something that we can't talk about because you forgot something.
Responded
to all of it.
I started the episode saying it was going to be another episode of Jeffrey O'Brien Needs a Fiend. And all of you guys said you just refused to participate.
I
don't know what that means.
And
so be curious about it.
I'm not curious about it. I don't want to know what it means.
And that's what makes it
don't
a bad
say,
podcast.
Be curious about it.
I have a good segment for
then
later that
fucking
I... No,
because
now
dude.
I'm like, the show is going so poorly, I want to save it for another episode. And I might.
The way your brain works is baffling.
So 6 minutes in, you're like, I'm out. I'm going to start punting.
Minutes in, I'm out. 30 seconds in. You guys said you were out. I get that I am not always prepared for the shit. I'm saying it's snake eating its own tail, chicken or the egg at this point. Because now people expect so little that they don't participate at all.
I just don't understand why you're mad.
What's the segment that you don't want to do? You want to save it for better guests. And who
also,
will be on the show?
Even before that, what else makes Jeffrey O'Brien Needs a Fiend?
It's about talking about the success of the podcast, workplace squabbles, etc. Stories from when we used to make Jeffrey the dumbass.
Stories from when we used to. We still do.
That's true, but on such an irregular basis that it's hard to keep the audience there, right?
I thought it was like one video a month.
Once a month.
It's one HeadGum video a month, which means one HeadGum, like Jeffrey the Dumbass or off days, every other month.
Yeah.
As if we don't have the budget to do more.
We don't. Yeah.
I'm trying to quit vaping.
Haven't you said that before?
Exactly.
Probably. But this is 3.5% nicotine, And usually what I have is 5% nicotine. So,
so you're going down. But are you using
that is it actually gonna help
as much?
Yeah. Yes, or, if not more, because it's less nicotine.
But I imagine that's still helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Will
they have a 1% that I'm gonna go to after this.
Will told us about a vape that he saw in London, because they just announced that they're trying to ban vaping, where you put a cigarette into it and then vape. And we didn't understand what that meant or how it worked.
I wonder if it's like those, I don't know if you guys know what I'm talking about. It's like a vape that you put like flower into, like actual weed, and it like vaporizes.
Yeah, maybe it.
Weed.
Maybe it was that.
I'm begging Anya to come in because she offered to come in to save the day.
Should we
I said,
just
yes,
start
please,
over?
Can
what
you
mean?
We could start over.
Why?
Should we start Jover?
That's good.
What
is that?
Need
Joe
to
over?
Start over? Like,
the how disconnect.
Is going, how is it
the
going to be different?
You not.
Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah. How
what
is
do you
it
expect?
Going to be
participation,
we're
trophies.
We're all talking right now.
Talking isn't participating.
Then sure do is. What we need to participate in. Obviously.
He doesn't want to burn the segment. This is unbelievable.
I don't want to burn the segment.
Do something that elicits response.
Okay, yeah. Anya's come. No, that's why I'm begging Anya. That's why I'm begging Anya to
What's
come
she
in for a burst
do?
Of energy. A burst of energy, dude.
Anya's known
not,
for her bursts of energy.
Oh my god, that's not doing something.
That's
just changing the vibe.
It's more something than this.
Because you're not, as the host, doing anything.
Because
you're just yelling
I'm waiting
at us.
To get some kind of. What's the word? Some kind of direction, some kind of vibe between the four of us,
we
so that I don't
debut
a segment that I know is going to be good. Because if it's going to be good, I want it to be Greek to all of us, new, brand spanking, on an episode that's going to be gold.
Because if it's going to be good, it's got to be vibe.
That's funny. That's really good, actually.
Just do the fucking segment.
No, I can't because this one took so much effort to get prepared. It has to be on a good episode.
You don't have a segment.
I would rather the episode that gets released be this for another 40 minutes.
Then why don't what? You just release the last one we did?
This is better than the last one we did, I have to say. The arguing is at least something.
Wow.
I'm like...
no, let's hear it.
I can't believe we lost episode.
Now it's an intervention.
I literally do not get what you're upset about. You're causing all of the problems that you're complaining about. Because you...
Gaslighting!
No, you're gaslighting us. This, you are starting conversations.
The whole show started with the note that you guys weren't
okay.
gonna participate. That you refused
what do you mean?
To even do
she
it.
She just didn't want to do that one thing because she
O'Brien
didn't know what you were
needs
asking.
A fiend. Yeah. Jeffrey O'Brien needs a fiend.
I don't know what
do.
That means. Nothing.
Nothing
it means
to them.
That means nothing.
Chums. It means like talking,
everyone,
getting on each other's
outside
shirt.
The.
And then you said the Kelly Ripa nipple
right
thing,
now because I'm
which
yelling.
Really meant nothing.
Kelly
and
Ripa,
then you,
really?
Yeah, two strikes and we're out, I guess. And now you don't want to give us the real segment.
And also, you haven't, you don't even let us get to it. If there's
get to
a, like, modicum of a pause, because we're trying to figure out and parse through what
because the best
you telling
episodes?
Us Kelly Ripa not
yeah,
liking
overlapping
pimples
dialogue.
Is.
Yeah, the best episodes are overlapping dialogue. So the slight pause.
Can you shut up?
Commercial. Come back and everyone's best friends. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Fondest ears, hear this show, often blear, you can trow, brand new stew.
You were saying?
I don't know. I asked you to be quiet because I could not hear myself think, and I couldn't figure out where I was going anymore. Because you were just saying overlapping dialogue.
I was gonna say, yeah, overlapping in a way.
Yeah, right.
This is.
Should we do Bond of the Week?
Yeah.
Bond of the
Gianna, who's your bond of the week? Or should I say Gianda?
Don't say that. My bond of the week is your cat.
Yeah.
She was doing some real
where is she?
Mission Impossible type of stuff back there on that window.
Yeah, trying to get that.
She's got the acrobatics. She's got the training and the flexibility to be James.
Absolutely.
My only fear is that she doesn't have the look.
Oh.
Anya?
Finally.
Believe this / you.
What's happening?
Anya.
They say they needed Anya Kay to come and save the friggin' day. When she joined the Zoom, I said hallelujah.
That's so beautiful.
Hallelujah.
Anya Zoom.
Anya Zoom. Anya Zero. Hallelujah.
One of my favorite songs.
Are you
hearing songs
now
on the Shrek soundtrack?
That's how I first heard it.
Yeah, me too. I was just going to say that. That was the first
Gianna
time I ever heard that song.
Hell.
Yeah.
Wait, the Leonard Cohen version?
Look
it's
at the energy.
Really
look
no,
how much it's since like a, Anya it's came cover. In. Overlapping dialogue. Gianna smiled for the first time as soon as Anya got here.
I'm sorry.
I like Anya.
He's mad at us for no reason.
I'm genuinely pissed at everybody. This
I
has
like
never happened
Anya.
Before.
So he sent me some really SOS type text, and I'm only here to figure out if there's any merit to what he said.
It's his fault.
It's his fault.
Okay. That's what
I
figured.
So. I really know. Everybody's ganging up on me.
He's
that's
like,
usually how it goes.
Yeah. He's really adamant that it's not his fault, but he's complaining that this is a bad episode and he won't debut a segment that he quote unquote worked really hard for because we're not giving enough in this episode.
Because so far, it's unusable what we have.
Not
so
really.
There is no episode.
You
so
just
far.
Said it was actually usable.
I don't think anyone, and actually I'm guilty of this as well, but as a good note to you, Jeff, I don't think anyone listening likes when you're constantly referencing how bad the episode is as it's happening.
Yeah. I agree, but I'm saying
you should
stop doing it. That's not that hard to just stop.
Yeah.
It's starting now. Starting now, you're not doing it anymore.
Yeah, try and see what happens.
Also, the part where Marika told you to shut up was really funny.
Yeah, she said she told me to shut
usable.
Up and then we cut to break.
That was an all-timer.
Yeah.
That was a great
one. It's fine. So the episode's good.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. I think it's been okay. And I think Jeff should do the segment that he planned.
I agree.
If
Jeff.
If there is such
do
a
it,
segment.
Jeff, what are you, a coward?
I think he's a coward.
Are you scared? Maybe he's scared that the segment's bad.
Oh, interesting.
He's bluffing a lot and saying it's really good.
Questioning whether there's a segment at all.
Same.
That's fair.
I think he is a coward, yeah.
I was really mad on that one episode where it was just questions.
That was a good episode. People liked that one.
I don't think so.
Anya, do you know that Jeffrey scrapped an episode with Gianna and Marika on?
Yeah, because she was the fourth guest on.
Yeah, I was on that one.
Wasn't it terrible?
That one's in the vault.
And you decided, you know what, we need to save this? A reassembly of that cast plus Amir.
Well, maybe Amir
it's
was
already
the
going
link.
Better. It's
but
already
I was already
going
she,
better.
Because
we told you to stop complaining that it's going bad, and you did.
It's not going better because of that. It's going better because Anya's here, and there's more energy in the Zoom. Yes,
Anya
you're the only one who came
last
in with any energy.
Time.
How
That's
many episodes have
problem.
You not released? Has that happened before?
I think you don't understand
Three?
What... energy is.
I do. I really do. Because I go through the record and I edit it.
So there's
I
three episodes out there that have never
sometimes.
Seen the light of day.
Yeah.
those are in the vault. You have to pay. You can Venmo me money, and I might release
unedited?
One or two.
Is there the files for it still?
I will never release it even privately. Basically, those episodes you have to buy the rights to, and because that's the way the deal will be brokered, it's like $10,000 per episode.
And then,
sense?
Of course, a cut off the top from the producers on the show.
I was going to say a cut off the top, yeah, for the producers
yeah.
on the show.
Yeah. Mm.
Yeah.
Which is actually half of us here, more than half.
Me,
Amir,
say,
Anya.
Yeah, I wouldn't even mind.
Yeah. So once you kind of divide it up, you're only getting a couple hundred max.
Well, there's no way that it's a majority, right? It has to be 10% per producer, which I wouldn't mind
Why
giving away.
Why are you saying
four.
That? Why are you
well,
saying
it's hard because. 4,000, right? Let's say we get four cuts of 10% to a producer.
Okay, but then what about
Casey,
what about the
you,
cut for
Allie,
being the
Marika.
Talent on the show? So that's like I'm double dipping into that pot.
Anya's like looking over her shoulder a lot. She's inches away from having to leave. Like, you looked like you broke into an office.
Can you believe who's even in the office today?
It's crazy. I mean,
Phineas O'Connell, right?
Well, Phineas O'Connell. We don't like to name names, but there are some A to A minus list celebrities.
Two-time Oscar winner.
Two-time Oscar winner. Thank you. And here's why I'm looking is because my plan is to ask him to be on the HeadGum podcast before he leaves.
Tell him I met him at House of Pies.
I'm not
Jeffrey.
What?
Okay, wait.
What if he fucking comes out, Anya exits and says, will you be on this other podcast? She drags him into that studio.
Okay, if Phineas O'Connell guests on the show for 5 minutes, I'll do my segment. How about that?
Wait, can I say something?
If not, I'm saving it for another episode. Yep.
Can I say something and we're going to have to cut it? Have you guys seen that his girlfriend looks just like Billie Eilish?
Yes, of course.
Everybody knows that. We don't have to cut it.
Just, okay. That's weird, right? Like, we're all on the same page. That's weird.
Anya, did you tell him that we sat next to him at
no
that place? And then you tell him replaced him?
I see. So did you guys exchange?
So
holy shit. That's the Phineas meter. It's off the charts. He must be approaching. Anya, what's in your kitchen? What's in your kitchen?
A head of broccoli.
Oh, kitchen?
No way.
We have, well, because the Doughboys are doing the a veggie focus month. There was a lot of random produce. Is that what you're asking?
Kinda.
I'm about to have an acai bowl. Is that okay? Like on
wow,
the show?
From where?
Do you mind?
Nature Well.
Yum.
It's got
Nature Well's, I would say, yeah.
It's
I finally had Oakberry on you.
Oh my god, how was that?
I hate that place.
Yeah, it's not very good.
Do you guys have plywood
here now?
On the
West
Coast?
Yeah, we have them here.
Oh, you have them there? They started at like the Jersey Shore. And then they like randomly the past couple years have been like everywhere.
Yeah.
Playa?
I don't know what that is.
Yeah,
can I actually,
it's like an acai bowl place.
Never heard of it.
Say a conspiracy theory that I have, or it's not a conspiracy theory, but I just don't understand.
It's not
where
about
all...
by the Trump.
You don't think he was actually hit by a bullet? You think it was shrapnel from the teleprompter?
I thought it was a bus.
You got thought it was a bus?
Yeah, I thought I don't think he got hit by a bullet. I think it was a bus.
A small little bus.
Mine okay, was just but about I actually want to
not even that small.
Yeah, what is Marika's conspiracy theory?
It's I just don't believe all of these chain restaurants are real things.
What do you mean?
Wow, cool.
They're
imagination.
Yeah, I think there's something weird about them because there's a bunch in New York that just kind of popped up from nowhere where it's like, I don't know what the origin of this chain was. And suddenly there's like five around the city. And at least Pliable is one that now you've confirmed the origin.
But yeah. Like,
I
agree.
It's a weird sort of thing where it's like another wave of fast casual restaurants coming.
I feel
in.
That way about Sweetgreen. I don't know who the fuck is eating at Sweetgreen.
We are in this office.
LA, kind of
oh, really?
But I
it's a Monday lunch. It's a classic Monday lunch. Yeah.
It's like it's a Monday lunch, but sometimes people will call it a Sunday lunch, even though it's on Monday, because the S in Monday stands for salad.
We've never
like,
said
oh,
that.
I can't wait to eat my bowl full of chickpeas.
Right? Quinoa dressed greens with a side of trout.
Yeah.
Go to Sweetgreen in
that's
the New York
true.
Office?
I do like the bowls.
You like
not that. Really. I
it's
go
hard because it has like
I
a
personally chicken, go to chopped
the quinoa. I was going to say. Yeah. With the quinoa and the arugula base, yeah, I'll sometimes do.
You got me really chopped nice. Once when I was in the New York office.
There's a few times where the greens almost get too sweet, wouldn't you say?
Yeah,
the issue is that Marty only wants to go to Erewhon and I never want to go there.
There's a lot of soy sometimes when you go to Erewhon. I was going to say.
I was really pressing Marty about Erewhon on the offsite. I was like, so what is good about it?
Can't get enough of that place.
And he couldn't give me an answer as to what's good about it.
Because it's
expensive. Other than it's expensive.
Well,
it's expensive.
Oh,
what's
in a name?
That's what's good about it, apparently, is that it's expensive.
Sometimes it's about getting the name, right? So it'll be like, oh, I didn't want the off-brand Lexus. I wanted the off-white Lexus, right? Drive that shit over to the Erewhon instead of the off-brand Erewhon, which is known as Trader Vaughn's. And a ton of people are there that are congregating because it's a fashion
from
show.
The
it's a fashion
Trader
show.
Trader Vaughn's?
It's a fashion show, and it's also a fascia show because the scar tissue is off the charts.
I think we have some Trader Vaughn's in Philly.
Is this the segment?
No, I'm shelving the segment.
I was actually going to ask you to comment on my new shelves.
I love the shelves. The shelves are demoralizing. Great. What Jeff said was demoralizing.
We're in our new studio storage room.
So instead of shelving the segment, you should segment the shelves. So
okay, so let's make something out of this. Yeah,
yes, exactly.
Turn these frowns upside down. Turn this fucking shelving into a segment.
Better shelves.
All right. Welcome to.
Shelf talk.
Shelf healing.
That's good.
Let's shelve it.
Shelf esteem.
Feeling shellfish.
It is kind of fucked up that I'm never on this show. And the past two times I've been on this show.
I agree.
He's sabotaging it.
Yes.
It's because you make him nervous.
Obviously.
You are younger and cooler. And that usually doesn't happen with employees at HeadGum.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's why it's easy to do this when piles on.
He banked on being the youngest and coolest for so long, and now you're here.
Yeah,
I would
like to think that I am a somewhat beloved figure on this show.
You
Jeffrey
holding that
is suppressing it.
Yeah,
you're making HeadGum Podcast relevant for the first time in 200 plus episodes.
Why are you so quiet now, Jeff? Because before...
Because I'm coming up with a fucking segment based on shelves. Welcome to Delve or Shelves. Basically, I'm going to... we're going to delve into each other's pasts. And if you don't want to answer the question, you can take that question and put it on the shelf for the next person. So basically, it's double or nothing. Sorry, let me finish. It's double or nothing. So if I ask Marika a question and she's like, that's too personal, I don't want to answer that, it has to be shelved for the next person. So then Gianna gets asked two personal questions.
Right.
And then if Gianna passes on those, it's basically like, don't fuck over the next person. Yeah, in a way. Yeah. Well, Delver shelves.
Yeah.
I would say.
Okay, on your left. But I guess that's the shelves are still in frame.
She'll be back. Ready?
Yeah.
Ready.
All right, let's start with Amir. When was the last time you came having had?
So arrived to somewhere with lunch already?
Or having already eaten lunch, yeah.
I visited my parents this weekend in the afternoon, and I had already eaten lunch.
You didn't want to shelve that?
No. I'm fine divulging that information.
Okay. Marika, who's the last person in your life that you searched for on Instagram?
How would you qualify? This is exactly what you did. The entire beginning of the episode is that I take too long to answer and you get mad. My list of all of my searches, none of them are people that I know. They're all celebrities or hashtags or a brand. So
is that Phineas? Sorry. Anya! Who's that? Matt Walsh?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Bring him in here.
Why don't you get Matt Walsh in here for the if any celebrity that's in the office comes over, I'll do the segment. But otherwise,
she should
it's
have
getting
just
shelved
turned her camera
show.
Slightly
towards.
So we can see.
What's the Gianna? What would you say? None of these are good.
Look how fucking nervous you get when you talk to Gianna. For me and Marika, it's like quick questions, no big deal. And
it's like quick cuts.
But I guess.
How about?
I guess you could say, I can. Here, I'll shelve mine and you give it to Gianna.
Okay, Gianna, who's the last person in your life that you looked for on Instagram, searched for on Instagram, rather?
I have an answer to this. This morning, I looked for my friend Melanie's. I searched her on Instagram because she's on vacation in Europe right now, and I wanted to watch her Instagram story of her Europe vacation.
That's cool. Yeah, that's cool. What's one thing you would change about yourself if you could? Delvershelv.
I think I would probably, for other people's sake, make myself less, like, funny, sexy, you know, all
of
that.
You just want other people to have the space?
For other people to, like, have a shot.
I was going to say, yeah. Anya, is that Phineas? Anya? Is that Phineas?
Well, he said yes to being on a HeadGum show, but not with you specifically.
I have a question for Gianna.
Yeah, what's your question?
How are youngsters these days using Instagram? Are they posting to main ever?
Yeah.
I think it's Pinterest.
I don't even use... I had a Finsta when I was in college, and I don't use it anymore.
It's nice that you feel free enough to have just one.
Yeah.
It seems like it's stories or nothing nowadays.
I like a story.
And not even that.
Sorry, 1 second, Jeff.
Yep.
I like a story. I'm not the biggest poster. Like, I am like a... I will only post my best moments, and I will admit to that freely.
Yeah.
Your best moments are really good, so that makes sense.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. I think a lot of people do dumps, right?
Yeah. I do that sometimes, but only like I'm not posting like anything ugly.
I do it if it's an event.
Yes, like an event, yes.
Amir's wedding.
A dump of like one specific thing.
Amir, where are the photos from your wedding?
Not really.
There's a photo, a digital photo album.
Why wasn't I invited?
And I think we had to limit it, the amount of people we could invite. Otherwise, it's just you have 400 people there and you're paying like
Yeah, but like the company's not that big.
It's pretty big.
I also think the general etiquette is like if you're going to invite some people from work, you have to invite everyone from work.
Yeah, I actually agree with that.
Well, what I did was I made a cutoff with how long you've been working here. And it was like if you worked here before the pandemic, it seems like you were more grandfathered into the invitation.
I worked here before the pandemic.
Before
the pandemic, but yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Plandemic.
Wow. Wow.
I think, right?
Oh, yeah, in a way. There's no way it was just an accident, right?
No, you didn't, but early pandemic.
Okay, early pandemic.
The earlier, the more planned, I would say.
So I just fucking missed it, basically, is what you're saying.
That sucks for you, Gianna.
Everybody at the wedding, I had to have known before I knew about COVID.
Exactly right.
Understood.
It's hard because the costs add up. I mean, it's like I know that there was like the salmon bar, but
you
that's a
invited,
lot of salmon.
You showed up
with a gun, yeah, and that's how
you
I was
were
able
Riley's
to
plus one, which she did not have.
Raw, smoked, cooked.
There was a ton of raw salmon because it was like a sashimi. It also ended up being the whole wedding was kind of omakase because we all had to kind of trust that you guys loved each other.
Nazawa, yeah.
So yeah.
Do you ever do omakase, Jeff, or do you just talk about it?
Oh my God. Anya's energy is good. Actually, this is a perfect idea.
That's a genuine question.
Oh, sorry. I thought you were sort of antagonizing him.
It can be both.
That's true.
Did I miss all of Shelf or Delve?
You missed
no,
three-fourths
he stopped
of
it. Yeah.
It wasn't
you have
going
to
well?
Ask Anya a question.
Delve or Shelf didn't really work.
Okay, well, it's come up with weird because you came up spot. With it on the spot, right?
Exactly. I think I've done omakase once or twice, but I don't do
you
it
don't even
regularly.
Remember?
I did it. I know I did it.
You're lying.
I've done it twice.
You're making it up right now as we go along.
No, I've done it. I did it once in Sherman Oaks, and I did it once with my like
Sherman
industry.
Sherman Oaks has omakase?
Marika, you don't know the sushi sheen out here.
The sushi sheen?
The sushi sheen, yeah.
You don't know the sushi sheen. Yeah, you don't funny. Get the sushi, do you?
You know Chef. That you can actually, yep.
No, continue.
I was going to say Sheen has kind of an omakase deal going on where you can trust that they're going to send you the right jeans.
Okay, that wasn't funny. So what Sheen. I was going to say was...
Yeah, tell him, Gianna.
I went out to dinner recently with Johnny and some other people, and
kind
he made us play Rosebud Thorn, which he said was a Jeff classic.
It's like a world classic. I didn't come up with that shit.
I've never heard of it before.
Wonderful.
Have you guys found it easier to breathe since Pyle got out of New York?
No.
He's still
you don't feel like that. He was maybe part of the reason for the smog?
I think Amir finds it easier to breathe since he had that balloon thing in his nose.
Yeah,
yeah. So what was that?
No.
That was like a rhinoplasty.
That
you
was
have a deviated
December.
Septum?
It wasn't. I guess my septum, which is the middle part of your nose, which like can be angled and closing one of your nostrils in either direction, was aligned. I did not have a deviated septum. What I did was have a lot of like tissue in the nostrils, which prevented an open airflow. So I was able to get a balloon sinoplasty, which is they put the balloon in there and inflate it, and it like cracks the walls of your nasal cavity open, and then they remove the balloon and those cavities stay open. And then in addition to that, they're able to do like a turbinate reduction, which is like they make the whatever tissues which are also in your cavity narrower so that everything opens up even more.
It's kind of like a popper.
You've reached your limit on talking. Shut the fuck up.
I thought that you had a deviant septum because one nostril was like pegging the other.
No.
How long were you sitting on that soundbite?
That's so funny. I can't believe you haven't played it before.
That one's new. That one's for today. And it's fucking, yeah. A soundboard's so worth a thousand words.
Jeffrey got it from his BetterHelp therapist.
Marika's straight up on Slack doing other work. She's
this is
so
what
bored.
I'm talking about, Anya.
It's not her fault. It's yours.
You weren't here earlier. It got better after you got in here. Plugs.
Yeah, because you stopped complaining.
Plugs. Next week's episode is going to be unbelievable because I'm going to do the segment that I had prepared.
Is
actually,
that
I'm going to add to it.
That's all we're doing.
So
it's been 45
mean.
Minutes. No, it's not mean. It's
it
not
is
mean.
Mean.
It's what would be
You're
mean is
mean
release
to me and Gianna.
It is.
I
people want to see me, Jeffrey. I'm
Jeff,
a star.
You're the host. So like,
I know.
Everything
you
comes
weren't
back to you.
Here. You weren't here. I had
I
shit.
She'll see. She'll see.
I also feel very confident that if anyone dropped the ball here in hosting the show and the
Is
vibe
this for
of the
tomorrow
show,
or a week from tomorrow?
A week from tomorrow.
You think we have more time to edit it into something usable?
At this point, I think it's usable, but I doubt Jeff does.
Jeff, you have to release this one.
Are
and
you
again,
kidding?
You have to do to... your segment that you're this segment.
No, he's not doing it.
At least
I do.
So
I am saying this with all in all sincerity, Jeff. Your one job is to bring the energy of the show, and like,
I feel
host
gaslit.
These people.
Like, I truly feel gaslit by this episode.
And we also feel gaslit.
I don't know. We're at an impasse then, because I do bring energy. I know that I don't always bring a great outline, but I did bring a good outline.
You can't get it. You can't get it out. It's not about the outline. You have to meet your guests where they are and get it out of them. That's like we pay you money.
I was about to say none of us except for you are podcasters, but that's not true. I'm not a podcaster, so
Amir barely counts.
This is unbelievable.
Yeah, you're right. You're supposed to like help Gianna along in this because that's the whole concept of the show.
And immediately you were mad at her because she didn't know the joke that you had planned that was an episode you did one time before. And because of that, she said
Jeffrey
she didn't
O'Brien
want to
needs
participate.
A theme theme song. Yeah, I was gonna say.
Like, what the fuck is that?
Still haven't explained it.
End of episode. I feel hopeful.
That's good.
That this episode will air next Friday.
I wonder what it'll call it.
Marty.
So what are you going to do, Jeff? Are you going to gather a new group of
is this
people
Matt Walsh?
That are
this
so
is Matt
much
Walsh
better
Phineas.
Than us?
It's better.
It's Phineas.
Here's Phineas.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Wow. Right there.
was a HeadGum Original.